Hello everyone, good morning to all of you. Wish you all a warm welcome to this session of English. With the right kind of coaching and determination, we here at Rotary English Medium School are always there to accomplish your dream and to help you to chase your dreams. So, before wasting our time, let's begin our day with a quote. Every morning, you have two choices. Continue to sleep with your dreams or wake up and chase your dreams. So, dear students, it's wake up time. Push yourself as no one else is going to push you. So, be positive, be optimistic, work hard and make it happen. So, now before moving towards our topic, I would like you all to put up the socks and think about the people we meet every day. Some remains in our heart, some remains in our mind, and some just fades away. Have you ever think that why would it happen with every one of us? Yes, we all are very social and we all are very connected emotionally with each other. And so we try to show our emotions with our expressions. Everyone can understand when you are sad, when you are happy. So we all are interrelated to each other. And so it's very important to respect and acknowledge the feelings and respect of individual. You all know that many of us try to do the quick judgments on other individuals when we meet them. So here I have put up a slide to just show you and make you understand that it's very easy to judge others and make quick judgments about them, their past, their present. But you will be amazed at the pains, the tears a single smile hides. What a person shows the world is a only tiny facet of an iceberg which is hidden from sight. More often, it's lined up with cracks and scars to reach the soul. So, never judge others. Respect everyone. Many times it happens, knowingly or unknowingly, we hurt many people whom we meet. Sometimes we make fun of people, sometimes we tease them, sometimes we scold them, sometimes we taunt them, and we make fun of their physical and mental problem. You might do it with your friends or your family members or classmates, but have you ever realized the pain that individual would have faced? They really feel secluded and detached. You know, they all lose confidence. And with this step, sometimes you feel that you are playing with their emotions. So I want you all to understand that each and every one of us have some or other drawbacks. So we should never judge them by our judgment. Now, let's have a look on our topic. Today, we are going to deal with the topic, the name is On the Face of It, which is written by Susan Hill. So, before moving towards the topic, we will know about the author. So, let's know about Susan Hill. She was born in England on 5th February. She is an English writer, author of fiction and non-fiction works. She had written many short stories, novels and fictions. Here, her famous novels include The Woman in Black, The Mist in the Mirror and I Am the King of Castle, for which she received Somerset Maugham Award. She is interested in plays and theatre. And we will be able to see her keenly refined writing, which she connects us with the play which we are going to see On the Face of It. So, let's have a look on the topic On the Face of It. Can you all tell me what does this title implies? Why the title is given On the Face of It? Here I have added you one picture where you can see there are two faces. We can go with two perspective. One perspective here which we can see is you can see a nature, and from other side you can see it as a face. So it depends on the individual's perspective how we take it. Some people feel it as a face, or some people may feel it as a nature. So this play will also show that the people which show physically is not always same. Internally they are very much hurt, and this is the play which will deal with the sense of loss, sense of alienation, sense of isolation, and it will also teach us that how to overcome it. Sometimes the things are quite deceptive. From it may look from outside, or sometimes at the first sight our judgment is different, but when you come near your view changes. So students, we have heard many times that never judge a book by its cover, and same thing we are going to see in this play. This play reflects the disability, where we can see the actual pain and the inconvenience caused by the disabled person. So at that time people feel detached. So students, it depends on us how humiliation and different behavior we try to approach, and we make them to feel heartfelt. So here the play suggests us that they need more empathy than sympathy. So let's have a look how to overcome and have a positive approach towards life. So the acceptance, the love, the compassion which we as a society needs to give as an individual, we are going to see in this play. Before moving, let me tell you about the characters. Here there are three characters in the play. One is Derry, he is 14 years boy. One is Mr. Lamb, he is an old man. And one is Derry's mother. So now, before moving towards the topic, I would like you all to please take a look on the scenes. There are three scenes in the play. So before moving towards the play, I would like to explain or describe the setting of scene 1, which is located in the garden. One can occasionally hear the birds singing and the low sounds of the tree leaves. Derry, a young boy, enters the garden slowly and tentatively. Tentatively means very, very scary. He is hesitating and he is walking, and his footsteps are heard through the bushes. Suddenly, he is startled, he is surprised to see Mr. Lamb talking to him. So now the play will start with the conversation between Mr. Lamb and Derry. Let us have a look. So here Mr. Lamb warns Derry and says to him, "Mind the apples." Derry shockingly asks, "What? Who's that? Who's there?" Mr. Lamb introduced his name and said that, "Crab apples." "What do you mean by crab apples?" "Crab apples are sour and orange in color. You can see here, I have attached the picture. These all apples had fallen on the ground, and wind fall means wind had made the apples to fall, and he's warning him that if you will go there, he could trip over it." Derry said that he didn't know that someone was present in the garden and thought it was an empty place. Also, he thought that the house was empty. Mr. Lamb comforted him by saying that house is empty as he was in garden. He asked him not to be afraid. He told him that he was alone and he should not be scared of him. So now let's see the next what happens further. Now when he speaks in such a way, Mr. Lamb tried to stop him and said that there is no need to leave the garden, and just because of him he should not be scared of. He also told him that the gate was open for everyone. It was, anyone can come and anyone can go. So, only Dairy jumped upon the wall, and for that he wanted to know, Mr. Lamb wanted to know that why he jumped upon the wall. So Dairy was very angry, and angrily he told for watching him and pointing him. So he told, were you looking at me? But Mr. Lamb told he didn't watch him intentionally. Occasionally, just he was observing the garden and his eyes stared at him. He saw him suddenly. And further, he told that gate is always open. All are welcomed in my garden. Then Dairy is also welcome. So, and further he says that he sits there and he likes to sit in the garden. The climate also is very wonderful. Mr. Lamb consoled Dairy, telling him that he knows that he can't steal the apple, because further he says that the young lads, so he says that young kids come to steal, and Dairy was not so young because Dairy was little bit big. And so Dairy was hesitated, and hesitatingly Dairy said he just wanted to come in. He just wanted to come into the garden. So let's see in the next slide. Further, Mr. Lamb told that he did the same. He wanted to come to garden and he did the same. Dairy told Mr. Lamb that he didn't know who he was. Mr. Lamb replied him by saying that he was a boy of 13 or so. Dairy suddenly told 14 and paused for a while, and he wanted to leave. But Mr. Lamb told him not to be afraid and wait there for a while. Dairy told, but he was not afraid. Rather, people were afraid of him. Here you can see this statement that for the first time, Dairy had poured his heart. He's trying to tell things. Up till now, we have seen that Dairy was very negative and he was not able to meet the people. But here, somewhere while conversing, you can understand that he is talking to Mr. Lamb and he's telling that people are afraid of me. I am not afraid of anyone. So Lamb asked the reason for that, and Dairy told him that everyone is afraid. He painfully told it doesn't matter for him who they are, what they say, or what they look or pretend. He knew that what people thought about him, how they behaved in front of him. He could see and understand the behavior of the people. It was very difficult for him to strive, and it was very difficult for him to accept the behavior. So further, moving towards the next slide, here Mr. Lamb questioned him, what about others thought of him? Why you are thinking about that? But Dairy says him, you think he is a boy? First look at him, then they think, says bad. That's a terrible thing. That's the ugliest thing they ever saw. So here you can see that how Dairy describes himself, what people talk about him. And further he says that to Mr. Lamb, that Mr. Lamb also thinks that he is a poor boy. He's not rather. Dairy says Mr. Lamb is afraid of Dairy. He states that anyone who sees him would be. He himself feels scared when he looks in the mirror. See the statement he speaks. This statement tells us that how much painful it would be for the Dairy to absorb the tauntings of the people. Here you can see that Dairy hated himself. What he thinks about self. This is called self-hatred. And when you hate yourself, it's very difficult to accept the people. It's very difficult to accept ourselves. Further, Mr. Lamb said that he was not afraid of Dairy. Dairy was shocked to hear that and insisted that Mr. Lamb was afraid of Dairy. See, now here you can see, even though Mr. Lamb says that he is not afraid of him, but Dairy is always insisting him, no, you are afraid of me. So looking at this and talking to him, Mr. Lamb suddenly asks him, when it would be a bit cooler, he would bring ladder and stick and pick vine and crab apples to make a jelly. He also told him that in September they get ripe and become a magic fruit, having orange and golden color. He asked him to join dairy in doing so. So here you can see that when Mr. Lamb tries to see the self-hatred in dairy, he tries to change the topic. You can see that dairy was hating himself a lot. And so self-hatred is the most dangerous scar which kills any individual. And this Mr. Lamb knew it very well. And so he decided to change the topic. But this dairy understood that Mr. Lamb has changed the topic. And so he pointed him for doing it so. So he told, "You have changed the topic like others." So here he added that Mr. Lamb didn't ask him about his face because he was afraid of asking about it. Dairy realized that Mr. Lamb was getting upset to ask Dairy about it. But then Mr. Lamb thought that if Dairy wants to tell me, so let him tell. So bluntly he replied Dairy that if he wants to ask, he want him to ask, let tell me about yourself. So Dairy got annoyed and said that he did not like the company of any people. Mr. Lamb guessed that maybe his face was burnt in the fire. So he says, maybe your face has burnt in the fire. He was so grieved that he repeated the sentence saying painfully. It was paining while speaking to Mr. Lamb, and he says, "It ate it up. It ate him from inside. He will never get cured." You just imagine how the people with this face would be living. See the face I have added in the next slide. See here you can see this is the face which is burnt by the acid. So same face Dairy was facing, and Dairy had also faced the same situation. So this just slide is for your information. I wanted to just give you the information, and you all might have heard from many resources and many sources that nowadays acid attack is the common thing. But people do not understand the problems or the pain which is faced by the victim. So here you can see the face which I have added. This is of Agrawal. Here you can see that this is about the Chappak movie, which Deepika Padukone has played the role, and she had brought in front of all the audience that how painful it would be if people do not accept you and you see your dreams shattered. It is very difficult to fight alone with the world. So this face is of Lakshmi Agrawal. Actually I forgot her name. So this is Lakshmi Agrawal, and Deepika Padukone has played the role of her. And here you can see there are four images of her face. Here she was very she had a very fighting spirit, and you can see that she tries to fight with the world. She finds the justice, but it's not with everyone. Here you can see that the pain in the world of Dairy, it's self-hatred. This acid attack has horrified Dairy, and it was very difficult him to accept the pain of the people, the cruel people who used to always taunt him. So let's see, we'll move towards the next slide. Now, as soon as further as we move towards the play, we can see that Mr. Lamb does not agree with him. Dairy experienced it first time and felt different. He liked it, but he didn't show it. So he asked Mr. Lamb if he was not interested in his story. To this, Mr. Lamb replied, "Dairy, that he was a boy who came in a garden like others. There was nothing different in him. He was interested in anybody, anything, in each and every creation of God." He further pointed out at a wall and said and asked him to see beyond it. So suddenly Dairy replied that there was rubbish. Mr. Lamb emphasized him to see it properly. Dairy told that there were weeds or unwanted plants. They are called stuff. So Mr. Lamb replied, for some they call them as a weeds. See, weeds, you all know, these are the plants which grow, which we removed it from the grass, and grows from everywhere, and they all are unwanted plants and we removed it. So here you can see the perspective of the dairy and Mr. Lamb. Dairy says it as a weed, but here Mr. Lamb tries to explain him in a different way. Here he says, but if anyone likes, it is a weed garden. So he called those weeds as a weed garden. He explained that there were number of plants in the garden. Flowers, trees, herbs, all sort of plants, and all of them had weeds in them. So it was not because they were different. All of them were green in color. So he tries to explain him, even though other herbs are good and these weeds are different, they are unwanted plant, he wants to tell that all the plants are green in color. All the plants have life, whether wanted or unwanted. So it's about the people, how we take it up. So if we consider it as herb, they are called useful plants, and if we consider it as a weed, they call it as unwanted plant. But for Mr. Lamb, both the plants were useful. In reality, he wants to say that they grow and have life like dairy and himself. See here, what is Mr. Lamb trying to do? Here he is trying to bring dairy's confidence and positivity in life. He wants to tell nothing is worthless, everything is priceless. We should value each and every creature made by God. We should love everything. So let's now move towards the next slide. Mr. Lamb tries to regain the confidence of dairy by giving example of plants and weeds. We have seen that dairy was totally pessimistic, and how Mr. Lamb tries to bring the confidence in him. So moving ahead, we can see that dairy replies negatively. Dairy did not agree to this and told that Mr. Lamb and dairy was not same. Mr. Lamb told that there was no difference. He told by giving example that dairy was young and Mr. Lamb was old. He had burnt face, Mr. Lamb had thin leg. But he did consider that so important. Further, he told that he was standing and Mr. Lamb was sitting. Then dairy asked the reason behind his thin leg. Mr. Lamb replied that it got blown off in an explosion many years ago. Kids teased him by calling Lammy Lamb and said that, and here further Mr. Lamb says that it does not matter for him if anyone teases him with that name, because as he does not have leg, it fits him. So here further dairy replied that he could cover his thin leg with trousers so that no one could see. See here students, you can see that dairy is always trying to run away with the problems. He doesn't want to face the challenges, and same thing he tries to suggest Mr. Lamb. So he says that why he should show his thin leg to others, because what he feels that it's not necessary that thin leg should be seen by everyone, and he guides Mr. Lamb to cover the leg. But in return, Mr. Lamb said that it doesn't bother him, as one day people would get tired of teasing him, and anyhow there were many things to stare at. At this dairy replied, he showed his face. See here, you can see, even though Mr. Lamb is trying to bring confidence, he's trying to gain positivity in dairy's life, but dairy is so negative about himself that he couldn't forget his face at all, and once again he brought his face in the conversation. So here Mr. Lamb suggested that things like crab apples, weeds, spider, then tall sunflowers, people like to look on all of this. So further, the next slide, we can see here that dairy commented that the names which Mr. Lamb mentioned were just mere things. They are just only things. It means that they all are non-living things. But Mr. Lamb smartly replied that all the things were related to each other. Just like beauty is related to best. See here, it's relative. The word is used, it's relative. Here, very smartly Mr. Lamb is trying to understand that every individual has his or her own perspective. For Derry, those might be just things, but for Mr. Lamb, they were life. He gives the example with the story of beauty and beast. He wants to say that a beautiful creation is related to ugliness. Listening to this, Derry got confused and Mr. Lamb asked for Derry's opinion. Mr. Lamb asks him that you only narrate me the story if you have heard about it. So further, Derry replied that often he had heard people telling the story. Story states that beauty is not related to one's appearance. Rather, inner beauty is a real beauty. Further, he says, handsome is as handsome does. So this is a proverb. Please underline this in your textbook. What do you mean by this proverb? It means that character and behavior are the most important traits than appearance. So here, Mr. Lamb wants to make Derry understand that how much beautiful you are from inside, that matters. It does not matter that how do you look. So it means that handsome is the one who does good, who have good deeds, rather than the one who looks good, who appears to be good. So moving towards our next slide, further, he said that once a beautiful princess loved a beast, not for his looks, but for his deeds. And when she kissed him, beast was turned into a handsome prince. Till here, Derry was fine and he was narrating the story, the actual story of Beauty and Beast. But then he said, if she wouldn't kissed him, he would remain that monstrous beast. He wouldn't change, and Derry too will remain same. Derry would never change. Mr. Lamb said honestly that Derry was right and he won't change at all. He wanted that Derry should accept that his face will never change. So Derry said painfully that no one would kiss him ever for his face. Even his mother kisses him on the other side of the face. He doesn't like it. Why? Because he feels that his mother does it as she has to do, being his mother. Mother actually does not like to kiss him, even though she cannot see such type of weird face. And further, he says he doesn't care if no one kisses him. Further, Mr. Lamb asked him if Derry want to kiss someone, like pretty girls with long hair, large eyes, or other people who Derry loved the most. Derry replied that no one ever allow him to do so with his face, and in future also no one will ever allow him to do. Mr. Lamb said that no one has predicted about this. This was unpredictable. Further, moving towards the slide, we can see that Derry said that he will never look different. Even though he will be as old as Mr. Lamb, he will have only that burnt face. Here, Mr. Lamb agreed. Somewhere you can see that whatever the reality, Mr. Lamb always agree with Derry. But at the same time, he tries to maintain the balance of the positivity and he tries to change his attitude. And further, Mr. Lamb replied, surely he will have half a face, but world has full face. There are many things to look at the world, and the world is full, and Derry must look at the beauty of the world. See students, these lines are important. Please mark it in your textbook. Here, Mr. Lamb indirectly tells Derry to stop complaining, He should see the beauty of the world he feels, and he should try to explore and appreciate it. Mr. Lamb feels that he should stop thinking about his face. He wants that he should know people may love him and accept Derry in future. So here, Derry cross-questioned Mr. Lamb and asked him if the garden was the whole world for him. Mr. Lamb beautifully answered Derry that when he was present in the garden, then the garden was his world. And further, he added that the world is not here, but anywhere any individual stands, the world starts from there. He wanted to say, Derry, that the world doesn't stop anywhere. In fact, world starts from anywhere the person starts thinking. Derry then questioned him whether his leg hurt him. In reply, Lamb told it doesn't hurt. Derry asked him if he suffered a pain when he lost his leg. So let's see what Mr. Lamb answers in the next slide. So here, Lamb said that it pained certainly at that time. Derry then asked him if it pained now, were the thin leg stuck to the real one, so wherever it is attached. Lamb replied that sometimes it pained in wet weather, but it was not that important. It does not signify. It doesn't matter for him. So moving towards the next slide, we can see that Derry is explaining Mr. Lamb that what he had heard people talking about him. So further, Derry said he could understand what he meant by all this, as he had heard from others saying you should take a lesson from those who suffer in pain and never cry or complain about their problems. See, you can see that whatever people talk to Derry, Derry is trying to explain Mr. Lamb about that. So in return, Mr. Lamb said he didn't mean so. Means he did not want to show that it doesn't matter for him. But further, Derry continues with his talking, and he says that people told him to look at those people who were in worse conditions than him. They told him that he would have become blind, he would have born deaf, handicapped, and have to remain on wheelchair. He may also have some mental disorder and may dribble. Means dribble in the sense, it means that he was unable to balance. The person who is unable to balance themselves, sometimes you can see that the saliva also come out from your mouth, and the person is unable because his mental status is not good. So mark that word, dripping. And then further, Mr. Lamb said that it was true, and Derry knew so much about that. So let's see in the next slide what happens next. Again, after speaking, he comes on his point. Once again, Derry said that all this would not change his face. He wants to say that it's true what people advise me regularly, but it will not lessen his pain. Further, he shares one more incident with Mr. Lamb. He says, one day he was waiting at the bus stop. He saw the woman passing by and the other woman talking to that other woman. So both of them started whispering when they looked at him. And further, he says very painfully, and he told, only I heard her, only I heard. Further, he said that she said, look at that, that's a terrible thing. That's a face only mother could love. He said they were gossiping and murmuring that he had such a terrible face that only his mother could love him and no one else could. Mr. Lamb asked him, did he believe what he heard? Derry thought it was so cruel. Derry stressed once again that only he heard it. It is very painful. He wants to tell Mr. Lamb that you will not understand that what those words, how those words had heartfelt him, how much painful those words were. And only then Mr. Lamb asked, was this only the thing he heard from someone? Daddy said no. He had heard many things too. Lamb suggested him to shut the ears. It means that he told that people are there to speak. People are going to speak. You should just ignore all the things and you should move on in your life. Let's see the next slide. So, as we move towards the story, we can see, listening to Mr. Lamb's word, Derry found it very strange. He told, it's so peculiar. He added that he couldn't understand his question because he speaks peculiar things. He speaks strange things. Father, Mr. Lamb said, he liked to talk, have company of others. He also told him that there was no need to answer his question if he does not like, if he finds his question strange. And he also added that the gates were always open. He could leave if he wanted to. Derry seemed unsure to leave. Here now you can see he started liking Mr. Lamb. He started liking the place. And then he said, yes, but here you can see he has fumbled somewhere. So further, Mr. Lamb said that there was a beehive in one of the trees. Some hears bees and says that bees buzz. But further, he stated that if you listen to the bees for a long time, they which means that bees are singing. See here, once again you can see the mist, that how Mr. Lamb explains Derry that people considers buzzing sound of bees to be noise, but for him that was a music. See, these lines are very important. Please underline those lines. Taking this example, we can see that Mr. Lamb says that music and noise coexist. Some feels noise and some considers that as a music. It depends on an individual perspective if they consider it as a music or noise. Here he wants to explain Derry that considering as music, you can enjoy your life. It's the beauty of the nature. And if you consider it as a noise, one can get irritated and suffer for the whole life. It depends on us. We should find a way to enjoy. It depends on one's attitude, how you take it. So here, very beautifully, Mr. Lamb has explained and tried to bring positivity in Derry. Here, you can see further Derry explained that he likes this garden. Here, he has once again tried to tell that what he likes, what he dislikes. So here, somewhere you can see that Derry is trying to change his view. He came there as he liked the place from outside and so had entered the garden over the wall. See, this is the shell cracking. Please underline the words. It means here, first time Derry has expressed his liking about something. He is disclosing his heart. Somewhere very slight, but very slight positivity is seen in Derry's words. Mr. Lamb cross-questioned Derry and asked if he would enter, if he would have seen Mr. Lamb, for which Derry replied saying no. He said negatively that he would never enter the garden if he would have seen Mr. Lamb. In this, Mr. Lamb also repeats and accepts, yes, surely you would have never entered in the garden. So here we will end our part 1 and we will continue our session. So let's end it here. Thank you.